Hi, happy new year, Columbia High School. When I think about this new year and resolutions, I think one that I am really focused on in 2021 is finding silver linings in every single day. Just trying to be positive and having my cup full and looking for the little things that are the silver lining of every single day. So today, just to be able to send this message to you, I'm going to say is my silver lining. I hope you have a great day, and here's to resolutions and a happier and peaceful and loving and beautiful year.
Okay, so my New Year's resolution is to not have any resolution. Because if you don't have goals, you can't be disappointed in life. I'm gonna go watch TV now.
Hello, CHS. I'm Tony.
And I'm Aiden, and this is Columbia Cougar News.
We'd like to kick off our show this week with a new segment that shows how one of CCN's very own isn't just one of our best editors, he's also got some skills in the kitchen. Here is Matt Baking.
Hey guys, my name is Matt, and today we're going to be making one of my favorite treats called
cannoli.
It is a delicious French vanilla pastry that I just love. Before we get into everything, let's start with the ingredients. We will need whole milk, unsalted butter, large eggs, granulated sugar, all-purpose flour, vanilla beans, salt, and any dark rum of your choice. The one downside with this recipe is that you will need custom molds to bake the pastries in. With that being said, let's get into this. For the first part, you're going to want to grab something to cut on and a device in which you will be using to cut. Struggling to open the packaging for the vanilla beans is up to you, but definitely you're going to want to grab them. I would also recommend the double take that I had when I realized that one vanilla bean was $13. For this part, we're trying to get the seeds out of the vanilla bean. We're going to do so by cutting the vanilla bean in half and splitting it down the middle using the knife to scrape out the vanilla beans. For this part, I did forget to hit record initially, but don't worry, you didn't really miss anything. From here, you just want to add a medium saucepan over medium heat. Into the saucepan, we'll go 3.5 tablespoons of butter and 2.5 cups of whole milk. And once the butter is melted and you notice that your mixture is coming to a simmer, add in the vanilla beans and the vanilla seeds. Once it is mixed in, remove it from heat and let it cool to room temperature. While your mixture is cooling, into a large bowl we'll go 1 cup of sugar, 2/3 cups all-purpose flour, and 1/4 teaspoon of salt. From there, you want to stir it with a fork, not a whisk. Once combined, add 2 eggs and 2 egg yolks into the mixture, and once again, combine it with a fork. Make sure you mix well, enough to where you do not see any of the original dry ingredients. As for the egg whites, you can use them for anything. I would recommend an egg white omelet. It's very nutritious. Once your milk mixture is cooled enough, remove the vanilla beans and add the milk mixture into your egg mixture. Thank you. Using a rubber spatula, you want to gently combine and fold the two mixtures together. You want to make sure there are no lumps in the mixture. Once done, you can add the fourth cup of dark rum of your choice. Add back vanilla beans and mix until it is well incorporated. Once done, cover it up with cling wrap and put in the fridge for 3 days, stirring the mixture once a day to make sure you redistribute any of the dry ingredients. Finally, it is the final day where you get to make these glorious treats. Before doing anything, set your oven to 450 degrees and let it sit at 450 degrees for at least 1 hour before putting anything inside. You also want to make sure there is one rack in the middle ready to be used. Next, you want to retrieve your mixture and give it one final stir before setting inside. Grab the mold and lightly spray non-stick baking spray into each mold. You now want to remove the vanilla beans, unlike I did, and use a 1/3 cup to evenly distribute the mixture into each mold. Non-stick baking spray into each mold. You now want to remove the vanilla beans, unlike I did, and use a 1/3 cup to evenly distribute the mixture into each mold. I chose to use all the batter in one batch by filling each mold to the top. You are welcome to do so, and it turned out really well, but if you want to go for some small, nice sizes, I would recommend only doing 1/3 cup into each mold. Once each mold is filled, place on a baking sheet in the oven and put the molds on top of the baking sheet, and close the oven. Immediately, you want to turn the oven down to 425 degrees for the first 15 minutes, and once that has passed, turned it down to 350 for the next hour and 50 minutes. Once halfway through the baking process, around 55 minutes, you're going to want to turn the molds as they evenly distribute the heat from the oven. Once done, let them sit in their molds for 10 minutes before removing them and setting them on a wire rack and letting them sit for another 45 minutes. Once done, and if done correctly, these bad boys have an amazingly soft and custardy inside and a nice and hard crunchy outside. They are extremely delicious and hard to stop eating, especially due to their small size. They are a great and easy recipe to impress your friends and family. That's all from me. Hope you all enjoyed.
Show your CHS spirit and support for the class of 21. Check out the Cougar Shop for CHS gear. There are sweatshirts, t-shirts, hats, and much more. The shop only delivers to South Orange and Maplewood, and they do not ship. If you have any questions, you can email them at mm@columbiahsa.org.
Some important dates coming up to mark on your calendar. On February 5th, the MAC sponsor talent show will be held at 2 p.m. Senior parents, you are also needed to help with the Midnight Madness. If you can spare some time to help out, please email mm@columbiahsa.org. And the class of 2023 is holding a design contest. If you want to see your design in the class of 23 merchandise, submit it from your personal email to columbiaclassof23@gmail.com. The deadline is January 31st.
Attention parents and guardians of seniors, parent ads for the yearbook are due February 1st. Please look for an email on jostins.com for all the info.
Those are all your announcements for this week's AHS. I'm Aiden Aronin.
And I'm Anthony Fischetto. Have a great week, CHS.